We farm, we live on a farm about 20 miles southwest of town, just on the edge of the school district. And I do support education, even though I voted no on this. I support education. I have two kids graduating from high school here. They both got good educations. They went to college. They have graduate positions. They went to grad school. And they're doing fine because they got a good education here. It depends, and education does not depend on a building. It depends on the teachers, and it depends on the kids themselves. And I guess I get a little upset when people are saying, if you voted no, if you are a landowner or a property owner or a business owner and you voted no because your taxes were going to go up, that you don't support education. We do support education. If each one of you wants to pay, who voted yes, want to pay as much as it would cost us to support this plan, I'd be all for it. If I had to pay $48 a year, I don't blame you for voting for it. If that's all it costs you is $48 a year or $100 a year. Those of us that own property, and we are not rich farmers, we are not big farmers, we simply own land. Same with the business people in town here. They own that as part of the reason, part of the way they make their living. And they're being asked to support this to the tune of thousands of dollars a year versus $100. So that was my main concern. I guess I'm also wondering when they're going to ask for an opt-out, which I'm sure you will, because of all the cuts that were made. You know, and if you do, that's fine. If it passes, fine, but that's probably coming too. One of the things I did not like about this plan was the fact that you were not honest about the gym. The old gym plan cost close to $6 million. The two plans, when you compare them on the internet, they have plans. They were basically the same, yet this one was only going to cost less than half the cost of the old one. So if you were just counting the cost of the gym as the cost of the shell of the building, which you probably were, that's not the cost with the voters. And I think you should look, too, for different ways to fund it. You said, I had in the paper that you got a bunch of donors towards the end. If you, I'm not saying you didn't do it, but if in the future, if you're going to do it this way, name the donors, put the money in an escrow account so it's there. A lot of people will pledge money, but then something will come up and they're not able to give it. And that would affect the final cost. And if it's touted as economic development, maybe the city could kick in half of one of the extra penny sales tax for the school. Watertown did this years ago. They don't anymore. But it's an option. If the city says they don't have any money, well, neither do the property tax owners. So I guess that's my major concern, is we are not bad people. If we voted no, if it costs us an awfully lot of money compared to what it costs the people that want it. We support education, and I think the kids get a pretty good education here in Madison. Thank you.